Hey guys, welcome to the Where Are They Now series, where we talk to Hillcrest graduates to find out where are they now. Today's guest is going to be really familiar to a lot of you, and I think you're going to really love it. Over to you, Tamika.
Thank you for being with us today. And for the record, can you tell us your full name and what year you graduated from Hillcrest?
Yep, I'm Rebecca Ludlow, and I graduated in 2009.
What do you do nowadays?
I am a pastoral and science teacher at Hillcrest.
Do you have any funny stories or memories from any of the teachers that were there that are still present at Hillcrest?
Oh, so many stories. There's quite a few teachers that are still there from when I was there. But I think one of the ones that stick out is for our muck-up day. A few of my friends and I saw the then Miss LeBroy and now Mrs. Pereira walking to her pastoral class, and we had a roll of cling wrap, and so we ran up to her on the premise of talking to her and started to wrap her up in cling wrap, and she just laughed and was like, "This is fine, but can you just come with me to my pastoral class because I have to go?" And so we just followed her, wrapping her up with cling wrap, and then proceeded to take her pastoral class while someone continued to wrap her up. It was great.
Did you ever get in trouble while you were at Hillcrest?
No, surprisingly not. Not that much trouble. I was more one to just not hand their homework in for subjects I wasn't a fan of. That's probably the worst thing I did at school. So got called in on report writing days once or twice to finish off assessments I hadn't done. But apart from that, kept it out of trouble, mostly.
Do you have any fond memories that you'd like to share or experiences that you had while you were at Hillcrest?
I couldn't narrow it down, so I have two. The first one was our Year 10 horse camp. There was a horse virus at the time. And so we couldn't take our horses off the property at school. So we went and did a trail ride through the high country with a company, and it was so much fun going up through all the mountains and riding these different horses. It was really good fun with a small group of people. Mr. Smithard was there. It was fantastic. And then on the way back, we're in this little country town, and the Land Rover decided to stop working. It wouldn't turn back on after we stopped for lunch. And so we were so excited because there was a nature strip down the middle of the main road, and we started making these grand plans just to camp in the middle of this little town on the Friday night. But then the tow truck came and we all went home, so. And then my second one was during the Year 12 last day, last assembly, the school organized for the preps to make bookmarks for the Year 12s. So we each got given these bookmarks that the preps had made, which was amazing. And I was so lucky because my little brother was in prep when I was in Year 12, and the school organized for him to make my bookmark and give it to me. And it was a huge surprise. And I was just so very grateful and blessed that's what they did for me. And it was such an amazing experience, because as I was finishing my school, he was just starting his school journey. So yeah, it was fantastic.
So what was your relationship with God like then, and what's it like now?
Yeah, definitely has grown and is different from when I was in school. So I was really lucky and have grown up in a Christian family my whole life. But I think since finishing school, I've learned to really trust God to guide me more where he wants me to be. And so when you first start putting that level of trust in when it comes to like jobs and what you need to go to and all those sorts of decisions, it can be really scary. And even scarier can be the fact that sometimes where God wants to lead you is there's usually a challenge or something that you need to do that you might not be super comfortable with. I think I've grown as a Christian, matured, and have learned to trust God a lot more. So the things are still scary sometimes where God's leading, but I just trust that he's got his ultimate plan is going to work out, and I'll be a better person once I go through the challenge or the new experience.
And lastly, do you have any advice or a Bible verse that you would like to share with our current students of Hillcrest?
Definitely. just remember that there is a time for everything. So in Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verses 1 to 8, it's a little bit of a long one, sorry guys, but it says, there is a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heavens, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to search and a time to give up, a time to keep and a time to throw away, a time to tear and a time to mend, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, and a time for war and a time for peace. And so while we live through all of those different times, I always encourage everyone, and especially my pastoral class and every student at our school, to sort of follow the directions of the Micah 6:8, which is to act justly, love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God.
Thank you for joining us. It was so nice to chat with you and find out a little bit more about your past history. Thank you guys. Have a great day.